Hello student, welcome back. This is Vasan Naik from Canara Engineering College. In the previous session, we have studied multiplexer. In this session, we will see demultiplexer. So we will take a problem, implement the following function using demultiplexer. Two functions are given, function 1 and function 2 of 3 variable. These two functions you have to implement by using a demultiplexer, 1:8 demultiplexer. Before we proceed, what is a demultiplexer? What is a demultiplexer? So a demultiplexer is an electronic device which has got one input and many output. So demultiplexer is an electronic device. MUX is an electronic device which has one input and many output. Many output, one input and many output, and this one input is moved to the one of the output depending on the control signal. Depending on the control signals, one input is moved to the one of the output. So normally it looks like this. Let me draw a demultiplexer diagram here. So, as I said, demultiplexer has got one input. So, let me draw this one. Let me draw 8:1 demux. 1:8 demux. What do you mean by 1:8? It has got one input. Let me call this input as a D in. And how many outputs are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And I will call this output as a Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4, Y5, Y6 and Y7. So here 8 outputs, Y0 to Y7, and I will write here it is 1:8 demux. That means this one input is moved to one of the output, any one of the output, depending on the control signal, whatever I call ABC. For example, if the ABC value is 0, 0, 0, first line will get selected, and if the input is 1, then 1 is moved to the first line. Output Y0 is equal to 1. Otherwise, if ABC is equal to 0, 0, 1, then second line will get selected and input will be moved to Y1. Suppose if it is 1, 1, 1, then seventh line will be selected and input is moved to seventh line. So multiplexer is a many to one. Demultiplexer is a reverse of process of multiplexing, and it is called as one to many. That is the difference between demultiplexer and a multiplexer. So in this diagram, two functions are given, F1, F2, F3, and you can see the min terms are 0, 1, 2, 3, 7, 5. That means you can use 1 to 8 demux because we have maximum number min term is here 7. And this is the input. Based on the control signal, one of the output will be active. So to implement the function 1 requires min term 0, min term 3, min term 7. So I will connect all 0, 3 and 7 to a OR gate, and I will call the output of the OR gate as a function 1. Similarly, I will connect 1 to 5 to a OR gate, and output of this OR gate I will call as a function 2. So in this way, you can implement a demultiplexer. So multiplexer is a 1 to many to 1. Demultiplexer is a 1 to many. And we have one more concept that is called as a decoder that we'll see in the next session. So dear students, we'll take one more problem. In this problem, I am going to explain decoder. So far I have explained you, one is multiplexer. So let me repeat, multiplexer is a device which has got one in, many input and one output. So it is many to one. And we have discussed demultiplexer. Demultiplexer is a device which has one to many, one input and many output. And one more thing is we are using, that is decoder. This is also data processing circuit, decoder. What is the difference between decoder and demux? Decoder is similar to demux. In case of decoder, it doesn't have any input. For example, if I take demux, this has got input and output, and based on, and it has got some control lines A, B, C. Output is Y0 to Y7 and input is Dn. But in case of decoder, it doesn't have input, it doesn't have data input. For example, decoder is something like this. Decoder doesn't have data input. So let me erase this one. Decoder has got only this much of this one. Only contains this much. So decoder, I can write now, this one I can write something like 3-8 decoder. 3-8 decoder means it has got 3 control lines and 8 output lines. Based on the control signal, one of the lines will get selected, one of the lines gets selected, that is called as a decoder. So please remember, there's a difference between decoder and demultiplexer. Demultiplexer has got input, but decoder doesn't have input. It has got only control signal. Based on the control signal, one of the line will get selected at the output. So now implement this problem by using a 3:8 decoder. And we have three functions here, function 1, function 2 and function 3. All are three variable functions. So to implement this one, I will take 3 OR gate and I will connect particular minterms to that OR gate. For example, to implement function 1, I will connect 0, 4 and 6 minterm. To implement function 2, I will connect 0, 5 and 0, sorry, yeah, 0 and 5. To implement function 3, I will connect 1, 2, 3, 7. So like this way, the function is implemented. And control lines are A, B, C. Control lines are A, B, C. Based on the control signals, particular line will get selected and that output moves to the through OR gate to the function. Now you can use demultiplexer IC, demultiplexer IC as a decoder. Only thing you have to do is you have to ground the input line. For example, this is the input. If I ground it, then it works like a decoder. If I don't ground it, then it works like a demultiplexer. If I don't ground it, then it is a demultiplexer. I can call this as a demultiplexer. And if you ground this one, then it works like a decoder. In decoder, we doesn't have data input. We have only control line and output signals. Thank you.